Thank you for making me a part of this wonderful session. And I think the future is going to be when the diagnostics are combined with therapeutics. So although it is about intra-op OCT, but I think that is going to be there for everything that comes in future. So if you look at the simplest of the things, and that is Desmet's membrane detachment, there is an algorithm for this in which we inject either air or gas. And if you look at this, if you didn't have the intra-op OCT microscope and if you just injected the air bubble, you would think you are done and you would be, you know, ready to leave the OR. But if you look at the intra-op OCT microscope, you would see that you are not done. And this has to be there for a good, good 2 to 5 minutes so that this kind of clears up and then this gets attached and then you know that you are completely done. So this just helps you on the table itself to titrate what is your endpoint without having to follow it up in the next post-operative follow-up day. Now this case was referred to us for corneal transplantation and we did an AS OCT. And again in these cases, if you do gas injection, this is what you get. So what did you do? You deferred a corneal transplantation procedure. You didn't have to do it because you addressed it in time and you did it in a dynamic manner by looking at where the scroll was and subsequently injecting the gas there. Now again in this case, which was again a Desmet's membrane detachment after corneal transplantation procedure, look at this Desmet's membrane detachment there. And once you put the air bubble, you would again think you're done because your air bubble is in there, but you're not done because there's some gap which is still there. So when you go and give those tab incisions there, and when you put that air bubble again, then you know that it is pretty attached. And now you know that you are done. So these subtle things can only be seen on the continuous intra-op OCT microscope. Again, the classical technique of big bubble DALC, we used to imagine earlier where our big bubble is and where the air has gone. But when you give the nick on the overlying stromal layers, just look at the way in such a live, like a live show, the Desmet's membrane obliges you and marches towards the overlying stromal layers. So you know exactly that your air bubble is coming out, the Desmet's membrane is marching over there, and you are in the correct place. And then when you push viscoelastic there, just like a kangaroo's pouch, it inflates again, and then you know that you are, you know, at the correct plane, and then these overlying stromal layers can be excised. This is a bare Desmet's membrane. You are extraocular. You have not entered the eye, and yet you have done a corneal transplantation procedure and given vision to the patient. Now, again, you can do intrastromal fluid drainage for acute high drops, such as in this case. And then it just clears up over a period of time. And this is possible because you can also do the drainage through the cysts which are present in the acute high drops through this. Now, again, when you are doing a layer-by-layer kind of a slit procedure or a layer-by-layer corneal transplantation procedure, then just by comparing it with the adjacent part of the cornea, you know at what level you are dissecting, again, without having to imagine it. Now, this was a case which was referred to us, again, for corneal transplantation, and we did a slit procedure using the intra-op OCT microscope, and it's cleared up. You didn't have to do a corneal transplantation procedure because you knew at what level you are dissecting after removing the pannus. So this is to show the same that if you have, there's an eye there, it looks as though there's no eye there, but if you do layer by layer dissection, again taking the help of the intra-op OCT microscope, you'll realize that there's actually an eye there. And these cases are not hopeless, and actually you can give them vision if you do a layer-by-layer dissection which is titrated. Now again, for your DSEC surgeries, when you put a graft, especially in cases of hazy corneas, you can see that this is a posterior lamellar lenticule there. You put air bubble, and again you think you are done. But look at these gaps which are there, and look at this gap there which comes up when you hydrate the wound. So you know that it is not completely done, and you have to go and address that again. But if you didn't have this intra-op OCT microscope, you would have to do the same procedure maybe the next day. And this is just for the orientation of your DMEC graft, which is so clearly and so easily visible here. And when you're putting it inside the anterior chamber, you can put it in the correct, this is an upside down orientation. So you flip it and you put it in the correct orientation. And when you put it in the correct orientation and you see that it is pretty much attached, this is the post-op picture that you get. that you also can't make out, I also can't make out, that there was ever a graft there. And a corneal transplantation procedure has been done. And this is the last one that is there. That is when you have an intrastromal lenticule. This is actually marrying of the intraop OCT microscope with the SMILE procedure. And if this lenticule, you cannot figure out where it is, you've done too much of needling and you don't know where it is, you can straight away take the patient to the intraop OCT microscope, see where your level of the lenticule is. Even if the small bits and pieces of the lenticule are left, you can take this out. And we got two publications out of this. And mind you, each of these cases that I've shown is already published in literature. So it just helps you to see the third dimension. And I'm sure in all the other specialties also, the diagnostics would be married to the therapeutics to get a better insight into them on the day of the surgery itself, rather than having to figure out in the post-op period. And this is the publication of the intrastromal fluid drainage, which was AS-OCT guided for management of acute hydrops. So in the last 1.5 years, we've got 20 publications out of this intraoperative OCT guided corneal surgeries, and it is here to stay, and I'm sure it is going to get better and better. It needs to add numbers to it, which as of now are not there, but in future, it is going to tell us micron by micron where we are dissecting. Thank